It's April and I've got a great shoulder-friendly walk with weights. Grab your lightest dumbbells and let's go. All right, killer bees, go ahead and have your dumbbells completely out of the way and let's get moving and grooving with, not arm circles. We're gonna do arm swings with some high knees. You guys, I literally have a note on my whiteboard that says, Paula, don't do arm circles, because you know I was going to. This is my Pavlovian thing when we start these workouts, is we get started with arm circles and high knees. And you guys, welcome to the workout. I'm Paula B. I write myself notes. I'm your best middle-aged fitness friend. And around here, we are all about making peace with your menopausal body by finding a healthy weight and moving in ways that feel like self-love. And today, being very, very kind to our shoulders, hopefully will feel a lot like self-love. Let me start off with my stern mama face and a little bit of an admonition to you, my friends. If you are in pain, there is nothing about this workout that is gonna help you not be in pain. Like, please go see your doctor and get some physical therapy. The only thing that actually helps alleviate pain is physical therapy. Today's workout is really meant to help you get stronger, of course, and get you a nice cardio workout, do some toning for your whole body. It's good for your muscles, it's good for your bones, it's good for your body. Unless you are in pain. Don't be in pain, please. Let's go ahead and do some arm crossers with booty kickers, keeping it nice and low, moving through your range of motion. I will tell you that your range of motion is exactly where you should stay for everything today. There might be some exercises that I do today that still aren't great for your shoulders. I'm doing my best. We don't have anything overhead. Blossom, you're fine. I knew she was gonna do that too. Don't mind Blossom. We'll just ignore what she's doing over there. Just take a little bathing. But anyways, you guys, we're doing what's best for us today and every day. Today is meant to be a nice moderate workout, meant to help you get your health goals, no matter what they might be, whether that is weight loss or body shaping or general health, and staying pain-free as long as we can. You guys, let's go ahead and do some welcome to my homes. And let me tell you, here's what it looks like. You actually do not need to have dumbbells for anything today. If having dumbbells in your hand already takes you out of the shoulder friend zone, please, please, please feel free to keep it hands-free today. This is meant to be a fun cardio workout, and we're just getting a little bit of extra toning to it by having something very light in our hands. Here's what it looks like. I've got the handy dandy gym boss here. Set for intervals of 30 seconds, and none of those are rest. We're going back and forth between walking and other cardio toning, low impact, no overhead moves, no transitions to the ground kind of exercises that you are welcome to take at whatever pace feels best for you. We're gonna go ahead and get started with walking, so let's go ahead and do that. If you would like to have dumbbells in your hands, go ahead and have dumbbells in your hands. You're fine. You're fine. All right. So we are starting off with walking. So here's what it looks like. We've got mini circuits today, meaning small, not too many of them, but we are going to do two of each mini circuit. So when it beeps, we're going to do wide open side tappers. And by wide open, I mean you're finding whatever feels good for your shoulders. If you need to keep them nice and low, you keep them nice and low. Here's what I'd like you to think about though. Kind of like yesterday when we were doing those clappers, we're thinking about really squeezing from the middle of our back. So wide open side tappers. Having good strong back muscles is one of the best ways to help your shoulders not be in pain. What frequently happens when we have joint pain, and by the way, when it beeps again, we're going right back to walking. Like I said, we're going back and forth between walking and the other cardio, kind of cardio toning exercises. So when in doubt, just walk it out, my friends. But one of the reasons why we sometimes have joint pain is because the muscles surrounding the joints aren't quite doing their jobs. And then our joint volunteers. You know, we talk about volunteering around here. Oh, bye, Blossom. Love you, sweetie. And volunteering is frequently a very lovely thing to do for your community, but it's not great when your muscles volunteer or your joints volunteer for jobs they're not supposed to be doing. When it beeps again, we're doing middle skips. It's your opposite hand and your opposite knee coming up at the same time. You can bring your arm as high as you'd like to. If you do not have any kind of shoulder pain at all, and this is not necessary for you, you are welcome. Here we go with the middle skip. You are totally welcome to do middle skips as high skips. Get your hands all the way up if you'd like to. I'm demonstrating in a nice shoulder user-friendly way today, but my friends, you know, maybe you don't know, if you're new around here, hi. Around here, you can always do the workout in a way that works best for you. And the way that works best for me today, right now, honestly, is keeping this nice and low. I do not actually have shoulder pain, generally speaking, but today, and here we come back to walking, for me personally, I've already had kind of a busy morning, and I know that I'm gonna have a busy afternoon slash busy evening, so I'm actually taking today at even, like, almost more of a moderate pace than my normal moderate pace, which, again, means that you can do whatever you'd like to do with the workout, but I know what my day looks like. I'm really keeping this as moderate as I can. When it beeps again, we're doing push. There's no crunch because there's nothing overhead, but we're just gonna push to the side, push to the side, and then push to the other side. So push and push one way, and then push and push the other. Again, if this movement does not feel great for your shoulders, either drop your weights because that might help, or do something else. Do whatever you need to do to make sure that you are not in pain and not exacerbating any kind of a pain that you have ever had. My friends, when in doubt, don't be in pain from your workout. Like, that's actually what I was just thinking about with my moderation for today. Here we come back to walking. And that is our mini circuit. So we're gonna do those three exercises one more time. We're gonna do the wide open side tappers the next time it beeps. When I look at my kind of big picture, okay, what does my week look like? What does my day look like? What does my whole month look like sometimes? It helps me make really informed choices about how hard I can go on any one exercise or one workout rather. And I happen to know, because I've done this a few times, that walking with weights workouts, here we go with those wide open side tappers, excuse me, side tappers, not side kicks. So I happen to know that when we do walking with weights workouts, that sometimes they get right to the edge of moderate slash not moderate anymore. And I know going into this one that I really need to keep it as moderate as I can. That means for me that I could have gone down in weights if I had something lighter than this, if I wanted to. That's one way to do it. I also could have made this a shorter workout. Here we come back to walking. Or what I am doing is I'm just really moderating my movements. I'm keeping this at a really, I consider this a pretty gentle walking pace. I'm not trying to be brisk. I'm not really moving my arms very much. Kind of keeping it low. I mean, it always is a nice low impact exercise, but keeping it really, really mellow. And the great news about that is that there is benefit to be had, by the way, when it beeps again, we're doing middle skips. There is benefit to be had from every workout, here we go with middle skips, that is not causing you pain. So coming back to that pain issue. My friends, if you finish a workout and you have pains, that workout didn't do you very much good. And that doesn't mean that you can never do that workout again or you shouldn't do working out in general, but it does mean that your body is sending you some really clear signals about what's working for you right now and what's not. I happen to know from my own experience, not from a pain standpoint necessarily, here we come back to walking, but well, sometimes pain, sometimes like deep soreness, sometimes difficulties the next day. I know that my body will send me signals if this workout is too much for me. Paying attention to those signals is hands down one of the most important things you can do. If I teach you nothing else in the world, and frankly, I try really hard to teach you something, like all the time. When it beeps again, by the way, we're doing that push. But if I teach you nothing else in the world, what I would love for you to learn, here we go with push and push and push and push. I would love for you to learn how to listen to your body. It is such a beautiful, beautiful thing to really tune in and listen to what your body is telling you. When you listen, your body has so much information for you. It's insane what your body is actually trying to tell you if you are truly listening for it. Your body will tell you when you're hungry. Your body will tell you when you're full. Your body will tell you when you're in pain. Here we come back to walking, and that, my friends, was the first mini circuit. When it beeps again, we're doing low swinging heel digs, which means that we're gonna tap our feet forward with, you know, tapping our heel forward. while our hands are swinging low. And what I mean by that is that you just see your hands aren't swinging over your head. Depending on your range of motion, what feels good for you, you might actually get your hands pretty high. You can get rocking with this exercise, but you don't have to. We just by virtue of having something in our hands, or even not, just by virtue of moving our bodies, are toning. We are getting all kinds of benefits, all kinds of good health is going on right now, not the least of which is your brain-body connection. But the other things that we've got going on are things like your bone density, things like your heart health, things like your muscle toning and endurance. We've got all kinds of good, healthy benefits happening right now. And here we come back to walking, just by moving and moving intentionally. You guys, when it beeps again, we're doing booty kicker elbow swings, one of my absolute favorites, mostly just because I love booty kickers. I was thinking about this somewhat recently, why I love booty kickers so much. And I think it's because I never notice how tight the muscles are in my thighs until I start doing booty kickers. It feels like such a nice stretch. And this, here we go with booty kicker elbow swings. Hands are swinging back and forth, really driven by your elbows, really thinking about pulling those shoulder blades together, having your core pulled in nice and tight. We're using good form, no matter how fast or slow or moderately in between we are moving. But when we notice things about our body, like, oh my gosh, my thighs are really kind of tight. Oh, how about that? I must be using those muscles. I must need to stretch a little bit more. Maybe it would feel really good, here we come back to walking, if I got on my foam roller today, for example. This is why I love noticing things about my body. You guys, when it beeps again, we're doing can-cans. This is the last exercise of our little mini circuit. It's a knee and a kick on one side and a knee and a kick on the other. Now, the thing that I get asked sometimes that I know is really difficult, because I've had this difficulty myself, when we are trying to listen to our body, here we go with a knee and a kick and a knee and a kick, and you can move your hands as much or as little as you like to. I do like a little bit of a reach, but not a ton. And in fact, again, today, knowing how I'm moderating, knowing how I'm thinking about my day, I'm not really doing too much bouncing on this one, not too much reaching, just a little, just for fun, but not enough to really drive my heart rate up well into the moderate slash not exactly moderate anymore zone. And here we come back to walking, you guys. That was all three exercises in our mini circuit. The problem with listening to your body is that the way we hear what our body is saying is filtered through our brains. And sometimes, I know you know this, sometimes your brain has a very different information for you than your body does. Sometimes your brain says, oh, no, 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 I need a cookie. Oh, no, 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 it's totally okay to push through this pain. Here we go with those low swinging heel digs. Hands are swinging low or as high as you'd like them to while we're doing a little heel tap right in front of us. Excellent job. Thinking about how we're moving in two different planes of motion. That means we've got our core pulled in nice and tight, always. Really, anytime we're moving, we're thinking about moving from our core, bringing that work right into your center will help you balance. It will help you be strong. It will help you with all of these motions, even the walking motion. Think about your core right now. Pulling in your core while you're walking helps you stand up nice and straight and tall. It helps your legs have more power when you're using your abs and your glutes to move them. But the thing about your brain, my friends, is that your brain gets really efficient at thinking old thoughts, thinking the same thoughts over and over and over without really truly listening to what your body is signaling you. Here we go with those booty kicker elbow swings, reminding me that I'm gonna get on the foam roller today. I've got a busy afternoon, but it's never too busy for a couple of minutes on the foam roller when I'm feeling a little bit stiff, a little bit tired, a little bit like I've had a busy day. In fact, it's one of my favorite ways to end the day is to just either get on the foam roller or hop in the massage chair and try and work off some of the effort that I have put in for the day. When it beeps again, we're coming back to walking. But you guys, your brain, I'm not gonna go so far as to say your brain lies to you, but your brain doesn't always tell you the truth. How about that? Your brain will tell you something that it has thought before. Your brain will tell you the same thing over and over because your brain, frankly, is a biological specimen just like the rest of your body. One of your body's biggest biological imperatives is to be efficient. Your brain does that too. You have a thought, it seems to get you kind of moving in one direction. Here we go with can-cans, a knee and a kick and a knee and a kick. And then your brain just practices that thought over and over. I like cookies, of course I'm gonna eat cookies. I think I should push through this workout, of course I'm gonna do that. I think it's best if I work out for an hour every day, so why would I stop? My friends, your brain just thinks on autopilot. I know it sounds so logical. Trust me, this was one of the biggest hurdles that I had to really kind of overcome. Here we come back to walking. And you guys, that was our second time through that mini circuit, which means that we are now on our third and final mini circuit. So what beeps next? We're gonna do triceps curl downs, which means that we're gonna be tapping out one foot. And that same arm is gonna be curling down and kind of twisting your hand out, really focusing on those lovely muscles that we used a lot of yesterday. So help yourself to whatever range of motion still feels good today. We don't wanna overwork anything. We wanna work the right amount. So triceps curl down with a little tap out. I'm taking this down a little bit slower, pulling on my core, thinking about this motion. Feels just right, strengthening the muscles that surround my shoulder joint, keeping my shoulders nice and strong without extra strain, but just the right amount of work. You guys, when it beeps again, of course, we are coming back to walking. Awesome job. Excellent. And the thing about your brain being efficient is that it really doesn't care what it's thinking. And I know that this is the part that's kind of hard to believe because it's your brain. You know, you hear it in your head. It feels like it's telling you really good information. It feels like it's telling you things you need to know. When it beeps again, we're doing twisting high knees, by the way. So we're gonna twist into our one knee coming up towards, I mean, I call it a high knee, but really it's wherever you can get to. This is a balance move. And so therefore, wherever you can balance is where your knee will come. For me, I try to aim for like hip high, waist high. I mean, you know, it really depends. Some of it's flexibility, some of it is balance, and some of it is not losing my balance while I'm also twisting. Your hands are right here about chest level though. They don't need to get any higher than that. And if that doesn't feel good, you can have them a little bit lower. When it beeps again, we're coming right back to walking. But your brain, being efficient, hasn't really thought about logically some of the things that it's telling you. When it tells you you need to work out for an hour, that made sense when you were significantly younger. That made sense maybe when you had a different fitness goal. That made sense some other time in your life, maybe. And honestly, maybe it didn't. Maybe this is just a thought that has been stuck in there because you read it in magazines. You've seen it on the internet. I mean, the internet never lies, right? We're doing ding-dongs. We're kicking out to the side while swinging our hands low. You can get your hands as high as you want to. Totally up to you what feels good. We're tipping back and forth, swinging like a bell. Ding and dong. Also like a weeble wobble, but we're not gonna fall down. You're keeping this to whatever range of motion feels good for you and whatever range of motion you can control. That might be a whole lot smaller than mine. That's totally okay. When you make this workout work for you, my friends, it works for you. How about that? It's right there in the phrase. We're right back to walking right now. And that was all the exercises in our third and final mini circuit. So now we're just going to do them one more time, starting with those triceps curl downs. When you can take a little step back from the monkey chatter, which is what I call it when your brain offers you information that may or may not be correct for you right now. But when you can take a little step back from it and say, okay, I hear that my brain thinks, here we go, triceps curl downs, that I need to work out for X amount of time. Or I hear that I need to work out more. Or I hear that I need to, you know, move more and eat less. I hear that I need to do whatever it is that you hear in your head that sounds so true, it sounds so right. I just want you to question it. Does this actually work for me? Am I getting the results that I want? Am I getting where I want to go with my fitness? Why in the world, logically, here we come back to walking, would I continue doing something that's not getting me the results that I want? Why would I work out when I'm in pain? Why would I do something that causes me pain? Why would I do something that really doesn't feel good ever? When you can actually be curious, like literally ask yourself these questions, like, oh, why would I do that? It makes it so much easier to understand that your brain is just offering you thoughts. Here we go with those twisting high knees. Whew, I have to slow this one down a little bit because I realized last time that it's making me a little bit dizzy. Not a lot, not like a rough amount, and not because of, my little disclaimer on the very beginning of every episode is if you feel dizzy, and usually, generally speaking, what I mean by that is if you are lightheaded because you are working out too hard. And truly, I mean, my friends, if there's an admonition to be made, how about that one? Don't work out so hard that you feel like you're gonna pass out. But here, come back to walking. Sometimes when I twist my head from side to side, though, I just like, woo, get a little more like vertigo dizzy than working out too hard dizzy. I'm feeling very good about my moderate effort today as far as that goes. When it beeps again, you guys, we're doing ding dongs. It's one of my favorite exercises. But when you can get curious about what your brain is offering you, rather than judging yourself or just simply doing what your brain says because your brain said it, because frankly, your brain, here we go with ding dongs, your brain is kind of like the internet. It's not quite as reliable as we wish it was. Your brain is repeating thoughts to you that may or may not truly be helpful to you. And being a little bit curious and thinking, I'm gonna say critically, but again, not being critical of yourself, but just thinking about what you're saying to yourself can really go a long way. You guys, when it beeps again, we're gonna do one more walking interval, and then we are done, right? We're not quite finished. I'm really, really, really bringing this walking interval down way low because the next thing that we're doing is balance. And I want to make sure that I've got my breath underneath me. You are welcome to have weights or not. I mean, honestly, for the whole workout, but really specifically for this finisher. We're going to do a high knee hold with elbow in and outs. So you're going to start with your hands here at your waist and your elbows out really wide. And then you're going to bring your elbows into your waist and your hands out wide. But we're going to be standing in a one-legged position while we're doing that. Now, of course, here we go with our balance. I'm going to stand on my left leg first. So elbows out, elbows in, elbows out, elbows in. It's a lot to think about. If you have to give up one of the things that you are thinking about, give up the balance and think about doing this shoulder work because this is actually physical therapy. This is a physical therapy exercise that helps you strengthen both your chest and your back, the big muscles that surround your shoulder joint. That's why I chose this one, because I do, here we go on the other side, I do want you to get strong in ways that make sense for all of us. Really noticing those big back muscles, noticing your chest muscles, finding them and asking them to work. When it beeps again, you guys, it's the very last time it's gonna beep, and I just realized that I need to look at my whiteboard again, because you know, when we're cooling it down, that I'm gonna try really hard to do arm circles again. Unclench your toes, and that was it, my friends. Let's do some arm swings with some tappers, bringing that heart rate down. Oh my gosh. And moving in a way, again, that feels really good to you. What I'd like you to think about honestly right now is just how loose it feels to not have anything in your hands anymore. If you've been carrying like your lightest weights in your hands, it just feels nice to kind of swing your arms and get them moving through that full range of motion again, wherever your full range of motion is while we cool this down. That was a really nice one today, you guys. Let's go ahead and open it up as wide as feels good to you. And then close it up. Give yourself a big hug and a pat on your back. Now, I do on screen like I do every single day. I do have an extended cool down for you, but I will tell you that that extended cool down does several over the head moves. So it might not be super appropriate for you. Feel free to do more of this cool down. You could just scrub back and do this cool down again until your heart rate comes down in a way that feels best for you. Always, always, always do what feels best to you, my friends. On the other side of the screen, of course, I've got your daily reminder about the 5-0 method, everything you need to know about losing weight at our age. I hope you have a wonderful day. Make sure you click that subscribe button before you go, and I'll see you tomorrow.